people with low cholesterol have a higher chance of dying.
What?
This confuses a ton of people on social media, including doctors, but the explanation is not that complicated, and it teaches us a lot about cholesterol and about how to make sense of these contradictions in general. So let's crack this. A recent study looked at a large population in Denmark and found that people with very high cholesterol levels have higher risk of dying. And interestingly, people with low or normal cholesterol also have higher risk of death. The lowest mortality was at 140 milligrams per deciliter of LDL cholesterol, which is quite high. The normal range is usually under 100. So this is what's called a U-shaped curve, because it kind of looks like the letter U. Now, of course, on social media, this study unleashed panic, with people saying low and normal cholesterol is lethal and we want it high, but not way too high. So let's take an objective look at the evidence and what it means. First, is this an isolated result? Is this study a fluke? No. In fact, this U-shaped pattern has been shown many times. It even has a catchy name, the cholesterol paradox. Here's another study in a Korean population, almost 13 million people, massive, and they found a U-shaped curve between cholesterol and mortality. There it is. Mortality goes up for very high cholesterol and also goes up for low or normal cholesterol. Okay, so if this is reproducible, it's a legit phenomenon. What does it mean? Low cholesterol could cause death, as many people on social media assumed. What's wrong with that conclusion? Why can't we just assume that and case closed? Because of the type of study we're looking at. Some of you are familiar with the three bags of scientific evidence. Bag one is lab experiments in test tubes or mice. Bag two are population studies, like the two studies we just looked at in Denmark and Korea. You look at a given population in a city or a country, and you look for parameters that tend to coincide, that tend to co-occur in the same people. In this case, low cholesterol and death. These are also called observational studies because we're just watching what happens. We're not intervening. We're not causing any change. But the catch is that many things can vary because this isn't a controlled lab experiment. It's an established population living its normal life with an entire history. People with low cholesterol could eat different diets, have different lifestyles, different diseases, a million things. Same is true with high cholesterol, by the way. We can't jump to a conclusion there either from this type of evidence alone. We covered the high cholesterol side before with the different levels of stronger evidence. So these observational bag two studies tell us that low cholesterol and death tend to co-occur, tend to happen in the same people. But these studies can't establish what causes what. The causality, the chain of cause and effect, is unclear. Low cholesterol could cause death directly, as we said, that's one possibility, or something else, some other variable, could cause both low cholesterol and death. Okay, that sounds kind of far-fetched. Some random thing is gonna lower cholesterol and separately causes death? How convenient. But actually, it's well known that, for example, people with some types of cancer often have lower cholesterol levels. It seems tumor cells suck up a lot of cholesterol. They've even shown that after chemotherapy, when cancer goes into remission, cholesterol goes back up. And it's not just cancer. People with gastrointestinal diseases like inflammatory bowel or with chronic liver disease can have lower cholesterol as well. So in several chronic disease states, it's common to see lower cholesterol levels. So we got our two basic models here. We're gonna try to figure out this mystery. Maybe low cholesterol is really bad, unhealthy, and causes death, or maybe low cholesterol happens to be there in the same people at risk of dying, but doesn't actually cause death per se. Very different implications, so how do we figure out which one is true? How do we figure out who's the killer? One way is to look at people on cholesterol-lowering medication, like statins. If low cholesterol is itself the killer, then any means of lowering it will cause death. So these poor bastards having their cholesterol pushed down by medication should die more. But if low cholesterol is just an innocent bystander caused by disease maybe, then artificially lowering it with medication should not cause death. The recent study from Denmark looked at exactly this question. People on statins did not die more, even when they had lower cholesterol levels. They did not show that characteristic U-curve, unlike the general population and unlike people who were not on statins. So low cholesterol itself is not the cause. It has to be a specific context. Okay, time out. How do you know I'm not just making this all up? Why would you just trust me on this? Well, you don't have to, because the authors of the study say it themselves. Our findings indicate a non-causal association, meaning it doesn't seem low cholesterol itself causes death. And it would be incorrect to use our data as argument against lipid-lowering treatment in prevention of cardiovascular disease and mortality. And finally, our findings support the hypothesis of a decrease in cholesterol because of debilitation and illness. So they're arguing for the innocent bystander model, that cholesterol goes down because of some underlying disease, and it's that disease presumably that causes death, not low cholesterol. You'd be surprised how often this happens. There's a media storm and panic over a new study, and all we gotta do is actually read it. And the authors themselves often explain the misunderstandings. Okay, but this so far is just suggestive. It's circumstantial evidence. So let's keep investigating. Here's another way to test the two models. If this innocent bystander scenario is correct, and cholesterol drops in some people because of some underlying chronic disease like cancer, then we should see that drop over time, and those people could be in trouble. But people who have always had low cholesterol because of genetics or lifestyle, they should be fine. They should not be at higher risk of death. On the other hand, if this innocent bystander model is wrong and low cholesterol is itself the killer, then it shouldn't matter whether you dropped to low or were always low. Either way, you're in trouble. That's exactly what this study looked at. They found that people who started out with higher cholesterol and dropped to low levels over the years, that group also coincided with higher risk of cancer and liver disease and more death. But people who always had low cholesterol didn't have those problems. So the problem isn't having low cholesterol. It's specific to the drop. And it's not any drop, because we saw in the other study, dropping with medication is not a problem. The issue are drops that are unexplained and that could potentially be caused by underlying disease. As the authors explain, our results support the hypothesis that low total cholesterol appears to be a manifestation of tumor activity or the consequence of chronic liver disease. All right, very interesting, but it still feels a little slippery. It doesn't nail it. And that's because everything so far is still from bag two, observational studies. We're still just looking at associations and inferring. So this is where bag three comes in, clinical trials. We recruit volunteers and split them randomly and change only one factor between the groups. That is how we test causality. So which factor should we play with? We can't kill half our subjects just to see what happens. Pretty hard to get that study approved. But we can manipulate cholesterol, of course. We saw in the bag two studies that people on statins did not die more. But we know those studies have confounders. Maybe people taking statins in the general population are also more health conscious and also exercise more. So we want a more rigorous test, a randomized clinical trial with a placebo control where the drug is the only variable. If low cholesterol is our killer, then lowering it with meds will cause death. If it's just an innocent bystander, they'll be fine. Lucky for us, this type of study has been done many times. Here's one such trial. They lowered LDL cholesterol by 30%, and deaths did not go up. This one lowered LDL cholesterol by 35%. Death actually went down. 30% less mortality with cholesterol lowering. Here's a large analysis combining 26 cholesterol lowering trials. Total mortality was reduced. 10% less death per unit of cholesterol drop. So, depending on the total number of people and the specifics of the population, we either see no change in death or less death with cholesterol lowering. So the opposite direction of the U-shaped curve. And it's not some weird fluke of one drug. Different cholesterol lowering drugs of different classes show a similar effect. People who have low cholesterol because of genetics or dietary change, in all those cases, we see a similar picture. Total death tends to stay the same or go down, not up. So as usual, we get confused if we're only shown a pocket of data. That's why headlines tend to throw people off. But in science, it's absolutely crucial to look at everything we know about a topic in order to try to make sense of it. Of course, that's much harder to do, but that's the goal. And when we look at all of the evidence together, the picture that emerges is that it depends why your cholesterol goes down. If you actively lower it with medication, with healthy lifestyle choices, or if you have the lucky genes, that's beneficial. It lowers your cardiovascular disease risk. It may even lower your overall risk of dying. It certainly doesn't raise it. But if cholesterol starts dropping spontaneously, unexplained, especially in someone living a typical Western lifestyle, eating poorly, not exercising, overweight, they didn't change anything, and yet their cholesterol starts creeping down over the years, yeah, that could be a red flag. There could be a chronic disease developing. Now, as we were literally sitting down to shoot, something remarkable happened. Remember the recent observational study from Denmark with the U-curve and how it was widely misrepresented on social media? Well, the authors of that study just posted a letter addressing all of this. Here it is. We are saddened to learn about the mischievous misuse of our observational study, a potential misuse we discussed thoroughly before publication and even considered whether we should publish this data. It is important to understand that our results are observational. They say nothing about the causal role of cholesterol in the development of cardiovascular disease or mortality or the effect of cholesterol-lowering therapy. For that, we have abundance of experimental, genetic, and clinical trial evidence. So this is really special. Out of pure happenstance, we have in real time the authors of the study explaining how the interpretation of their work that's going around is misleading. Welcome to the internet. If they had posted this a week earlier, they would have saved us the trouble of making the video because that sums it up perfectly. Okay, here's even more context. This cholesterol paradox, this U-curve, this is nothing unique. We see this pattern in many other areas of health. BMI, for example, body mass index. In BAG2 studies, obesity is associated with higher mortality, but so is normal body weight, a U-shaped curve, with mortality going up at very high BMI, but also going up with low and even normal BMI, and the lowest mortality point actually sitting in the overweight range. You know what they call this phenomenon? The obesity paradox. And the explanation is similar. It's not the normal body weight that kills people. It's probably an innocent bystander, because several factors that cause weight loss, like smoking and chronic disease, also raise risk of death. So you see how misguided it would be to look at this U-curve for BMI and conclude, I shouldn't exercise or try to eat better. I should try to be overweight because of this mortality pattern. It's confusing association with causality. The U-curve doesn't mean normal BMI is bad. It means that in the general population, many people who lose weight and drop to the normal range lose it for the wrong reasons, like underlying disease. The exact same is true with cholesterol. By the way, we see the same trend with salt. Higher mortality at very high salt intake, and higher mortality at low salt intake. And this confuses a ton of people who then jump to the conclusion that we shouldn't moderate salt intake because of this association, this U-shaped pattern. But we now understand the association doesn't necessarily reflect causality. We'll look at the salt confusion in more detail another day. For now, take-home message is, we see these U-shaped patterns because the norm in our society is to be a bit unhealthy. A bit overweight, a bit hypercholesterolemic, a bit too much salt. So the average is high, and for many people who drop down to the normal range, that happens because of underlying disease, not because of healthy choices. It's a very sobering view of our society, but on the flip side, it shows us that it's in our hands to have normal cholesterol, normal body weight, and low mortality all at the same time. It's not a trade-off. We don't need to compromise. We can have it all. Bottom line, be a little skeptical of these U-curves, and back to studies, observational studies, they're important evidence, but we have to interpret them in context. We can't jump to a conclusion. And if you're motivated to lower cholesterol, don't be confused. The evidence tells us it's overwhelmingly beneficial, and for most of us, very doable with lifestyle changes, and it can be as quick as a few days. I want to help more people achieve their cholesterol goals, so we're going to start sharing the best tips and tricks for cholesterol optimization every week, completely free. Go to this URL to sign up, and you can click the link in the description below. And we have several videos explaining in detail what foods raise your cholesterol and what foods lower it. So check them out, and let's crush this. Peace.